Welcome back to MacBreak Studio. I'm Steve Martin, and we have a special guest for this MacBreak, Brandon Fisher, and he's coming all the way from Idaho. Now, why are you here from Idaho?
I attended the, Final Cut Pro Summit.
Yep, our first summit? Only FCP10 Creative Summit. And I met Brandon for the first time. He's watched a lot of our MacBreak episodes. And one MacBreak episode in particular that he's interested in was episode 282, where I talked about batch exporting in Final Cut Pro 10. I said, you could do it. And I showed it, and Brandon's like, no, that's not batch exporting. So what he did is he took it upon himself to write this little app that actually does batch exporting. So he's going to show it to us today, so we invite him on the show. So you had your own particular need for batch exporting. Why don't you tell our audience a little bit about that?
Sure. So I had a client come to me, and they wanted to do, we did 40 interviews in 2 days, and that's a lot of projects to do each individual video as each person being interviewed. And so that's how this whole thing came about, is I went to this MacBreak studio episode and followed it, but it still felt like it was time consuming to do that 40 times.
Right. So let's, why don't you take us on your little journey through your software and show us how cool it is.
Alrighty. So if we go to Final Cut here, we have our library open. We've got some projects in here. What we're gonna end up doing is, first of all, we'll get this set up to be able to be used, and it was covered in that episode. But what we're gonna do is we'll go to the share option. Oh, wait. So the focusing thing. So let's do the, we're gonna click on a
project.
Me. Correct.
So you project. Start by clicking on a project that you wanna export, correct?
Correct, yep. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the share destination button here. And it looks to me like we've got this one set to the default already.
So that what that is a compressor preset that I use all the time when I export. And that set is the default export. A preset like you mentioned.
Correct.
So your software will use that as the preset for spitting out all these movies.
Right. So if for some reason the default was already set to master file, you just want to make sure that you set your default to whatever either compressor preset or other preset that you want underneath your share project. So if we click on this one, what we're going to do is then we'll hit the next button. Right. And then from here, we already went ahead and we've set up a folder, but if you wanted to, you could basically put the folder wherever you want, click new folder, and then name your folder, and
it'll use that folder to export to. Now, yeah. I have a folder here called Steve's Export, so.
Correct.
And the thing is, you don't want to click save, you want to cancel out of this. At this point, you just want to
correct
designate your folder.
Yep, absolutely. So what we're going to do now is, now that we've got that selected, we're going to hit cancel twice, so once, and then twice. So now,
oh my gosh, so much clicking, Brandon.
I know.
That was horrible.
I know.
Okay.
Hopefully it'll be coming out where Apple wants to make batch exporting part of Final Cut. But until then, this was a good workaround.
That's fantastic.
So once we've got that set up, we're gonna come here to FCPXporter. And I'll just say this real quick too. Make sure that you just start on the, in your list view, which project you're going to start on. So we're going to do this one right here.
So to clarify, you're going to select one in the browser.
Correct.
In list view, and
yep,
it's going to export from that one on down.
Correct.
So you want to, whatever clip you choose, that's going to be the one that's going to start from before it goes through your list.
Absolutely. So this right here, what we're going to do is then we'll go over to this little app here called FCPXporter.
Excellent.
And then right now we've got, let's say we're gonna do five, we'll just export the next five projects.
Now I noticed that the default is five. Why did you choose five as kind of the default number of exports?
I figured that you could just go in and do Command E, down arrow if you had less than five. It didn't seem like it would save you that much time. Again, I've done two projects, one that I had 40 interviews and another one that I had 192 projects in my library. So I just, anyway,
wow.
It saves a bunch of time if you do. Anyway,
so five is kind of the baseline,
right?
Starting. Okay.
I don't think people are going to see a huge time saving if it's under five. But anyway, so then what we'll do is we'll just hit execute here, and then this just tells us it's going to take less than a minute. Obviously, the more projects you have, it'll kind of tell you how much time you know, so you can walk away, get a break, that kind of thing. So we'll just go ahead and hit run. And then that's it. So we're going to take our hands off, and it's just going to go ahead and do all of the what I call batch exporting. So,
and look, it's going through the list and it's setting up and setting up for that folder. It's like there's a ghost operating the machine.
Correct. The one, I guess, caveat or the one thing to be mindful of is this kind of this process right here for what it warned you. So like 1 minute, that locks up your computer. So you make sure that you're not going to be trying to click around or do any other tasks while it's doing that. So
I noticed it just ran the script, yep. And now it's presumably crunching away in the background. Right?
Correct. Yep. And so if I click on the background tasks. Yep. And if we go to sharing.
Oh, look at that. They're all queued up. Now, that is batch exporting.
Yeah.
That is really slick, Brad, and that's fantastic. Yeah. I would totally use this. And this is on your website. Can you show your URL so people know where it is?
And all righty. So I have a website called fdptraining.com, and that's where you'll find FCPXporter. And
how much is it?
Right now, I've got it on sale for $20. And anyway,
$20 well spent.
I know.
if you need 200 movies exported out of Final Cut Pro 10.
Right.
Now, one other thing before you go.
Yeah.
Brandon recently took the Final Cut Pro 10 certification class, and now he's a certified Final Cut Pro 10 instructor. So congratulations, buddy. Woo. That's awesome. And it was so great to meet him at the FCP 10 Summit. And hopefully, we're going to do it next year. It was a great event. It was a lot of fun. If you want to check out more Final Cut Pro stuff, rippletraining.com. Check us out on Twitter. Check us out on Facebook. Check out our plugins. We have all kinds of training. So thanks again for joining us, Brandon. It's really a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you, Steve.
And thanks for watching another episode of MacBreak Studio.